Pandemi COVID-19 telah memukul berbagai jenis industri, namun di saat yang sama juga menjadi peluang bagi sejumlah layanan yang justru meningkat, seperti telekomunikasi. Nah, bagaimana kinerja industri telekomunikasi di tengah pandemi sepanjang setahun terakhir? Kita akan dalami bersama Ahmad Al-Niama, Presiden Direktur dan CEO dari Indosat Ooredoo. Thank you for joining us, Mr. Al-Niama.
Yeah, thanks back to me and thanks for having me.
Thank you. Now, my first question would be, during the whole pandemic, how has this pandemic affected the overall performance of your company?
Well, thanks, Pak. I think this is a very relevant question. You know, first, allow me to express our gratitude and appreciation to our customers and also our stakeholders for their trust and support to Indosat Ooredoo. 2020 was a challenging year for many aspects, due to COVID-19 pandemic and pricing pressure from operators. Despite all the challenges, the company has continued to deliver our three-year turnaround strategy and maintain its growth momentum. We have seen close to 12% year-on-year cellular revenue growth and 16% year-on-year EBITDA growth, driven by continuous solid performance and focus on operational efficiencies. The company also has successfully delivered a strong operational performance, including an improved video experience by 55% year-on-year. We doubled our 4G download speed and significantly improved upload speed by 90% year-on-year. This result then being awarded by OpenSignal, an independent research firm, to name Indosat as the global rising star for video experience in 2020. Our commitment to our customer have contributed to an increase in our subscriber base and data traffic volume. This growth has translated into an above market increase in cellular revenue and a significant and accelerating gain in market share. The approach to our customer remains simple, relevant, and affordable offering. We are deeply committed to always provide the best service and experience for our customer. Mm-hmm. I am very proud for my entire team who have worked with a full of passion to deliver the best digital experience for customers throughout Indonesia.
Mm-hmm. So now, as we try to recover the economy, your company could also be a part of this. Now, how do you see the government's efforts that has been put in to try to recover the national economy?
Well, back as you know, all of us are impacted by the difficult situation and struggle together, you know, to overcome this pandemic. Since the very beginning, Indosat already played an active role to support the communities and accelerate digital transformation throughout Indonesia. We provide digital tools and support, especially for medium and small size enterprise. So the SME contribute to 60 to 65% to Indonesia GDP and making it easier for everyone to go through this pandemic. We continue to support the distance learning program from the government to assist millions of teachers and students able to study from home. Our video grid network is already added and available to support this commitment for the second phase this year. We also supported the PNPP, National Disaster Management Agency, and many professional government as we operated in all regional offices in Indonesia to provide the essential relief for the communities. We are committed to support the government digital economy agenda that Indonesia must be able to provide 9 million of digital talent by 2035.
Okay.
I can say back, we keep supporting to fulfill the readiness gap and even improve our digital talent scholarship program. Now, our very own ID Camp program has helped more than 40,000 young people to learn to code, a skill set that opens many opportunities, including a new job offer at this specific time. We believe in Indosat. The ability to support the community in this difficult situation is among the enabler to our good results and also help us making a bigger impact to the nation. Mm-hmm.
Now, our business viewers but also want to know, back to the growth of your company. Now, what are actually the key contributors to your revenue growth for the last past year? And also, what would you say is the secret behind this achievement, if you would share with us?
Yeah, sure, Pak. First, it's really good you asked this question. You know, our strategy of continued investment in 4G network, as well as constant execution of our commercial strategy with an increased focus on operational excellence has enabled us to outperform the market, both in revenue as well as EBITDA this year. Mm. In 2020, we posted a total revenue close to 28 trillion rupiah. Our focus on operational excellence meant that EBITDA rose faster than revenue, growing 16% year-on-year. Mm-hmm. Moreover, the company also focused on offering relevant and affordable pricing, innovative digital services, and superior network experience. This all has helped a double-digit ARPU growth and positive subscriber addition. Cellular subscriber stood at more than 60 million by end of year 2020.
So for the customer side, anything new, any new plans for your company for this year?
This year, yes, of course. We believe that the trust and support of our customer and all stakeholders has made us come this far. You know, we are grateful to be able to launch innovative new digital offering to ensure that our customer have the best mobile experience possible. In fact, we are committed in Indosat, you know, to deliver the best in-class digital experience. You know, our MyIM3 continues app continues to set a new benchmark and become the highest-rated telecom app in Indonesia. We have continued to introduce a new innovative products to help customers stay connected, as well as business and education to continue to operate during this pandemic time. Throughout the 2020, Indonesia leading digital telecom, we have initiated partnership with both local and global digital players, you know, like Facebook, Google, Cisco, and Ericsson, as groundbreak to bring advanced technologies and capabilities to fast-track digitalization of the customer experience and deliver the best network improvement to Indonesia.
Okay, that's great to hear. Thank you very much, Mr. Ahmad Al Niama, for your time with us, President Director and CEO of Indosat Ooredoo. Thank you very much and stay safe.
Thank you very much, Pak.
Halo, saya Audrey Chandra, presenter di Sapa Indonesia Siang. Perbaharui yuk informasi yang paling baru, independen dan juga terpercaya hanya di YouTube Kompas TV. Jangan lupa untuk subscribe, like, komen dan juga share ya. Nah, terakhir itu tuh dinyalain loncengnya ya untuk dapetin notifikasi berita-berita terbaru.